Hello everyone, welcome back. Earlier you learned about air, water and soil. In this video, let's understand about the biogeochemical cycles taking place in the air, water and soil. Friends, do you know what kind of minerals are found on the earth? Minerals such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen are found on the earth. Do you know these minerals are found in a constant amount in the atmosphere? Let us see how, by the help of biogeochemical cycles. First, water cycle. Friends, we all like rain. But how does rain occur? Let's understand. Due to sunlight, the surface of water bodies gets heated up and gets converted to water vapor. This process is called evaporation. But how does this water vapor go into the sky? Think? Well, due to the sunlight, during the day, the air also gets heated and it rises. While rising, it gets mixed with the water vapor and finally goes into the sky. Up in the sky, temperature is low, due to which the water vapor starts to cool to form water droplets. These small droplets mixes with dust particle and other suspended particles combine to form clouds, and this process is called condensation. Due to continuous condensation, these clouds become heavy and they fall down in the form of water droplets, which we call as rain. This process is called precipitation. Sometimes, due to low temperature, precipitation also occurs in the form of snow or hail. Some of the water falling on the earth seeps into the ground and is available as groundwater. Some part of this water also reaches the surface through spring. Friends, do you know that we also bring groundwater to surface? But how? Think? Via well or tube well? Friends, some part of the rainwater also flows from the top of the rock, dissolving the soluble minerals present in the rock and finally mixes in the sea. In this manner, rainwater carries many minerals from the land to sea, and the same is used by sea creatures. Well, what's happening? The water evaporates from the reservoir and falls to the ground in the form of rain and joins the water bodies. And then again the water evaporates from the reservoir. So in this way, water is moving in a circular manner, and which is called a water cycle. Carbon cycle. Friends, like nitrogen, carbon is also an essential element for all living organisms. It is an important part of compounds like protein, carbohydrate, fat and nucleic acid. Do you know in what form carbon is found in the atmosphere? Carbon dioxide. Absolutely correct. About 0.04% of atmosphere is carbon dioxide, and its percentage almost remains constant. Let's know how from this carbon cycle. Trees absorb carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere and prepare their food by the process called photosynthesis. Apart from this, marine animals also absorb carbon dioxide dissolved in water and make their own shells. In this way, carbon dioxide is absorbed from the atmosphere. But what are the processes by which carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere? Let's understand this. Carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere by respiration and burning of fossil fuels and coal. So guys, you saw how carbon is absorbed and released back in the atmosphere. But due to different human activities, this carbon cycle is getting disturbed. Human activities like burning of fossil fuels releases a lot of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. And the main job of absorbing this carbon dioxide is done by the trees. But humans are cutting down the trees as well, which leads to the increase of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, causing global warming. Oxygen cycle. Friends, can you imagine your life without oxygen? Think? impossible. We cannot live few minutes also without it. Oxygen is necessary for the respiration of living beings, and it is also necessary for combustion. Around 21% of the atmosphere is oxygen, and it's almost constant. Let us see how the amount of oxygen remains constant in the atmosphere. Humans, animals take oxygen through the process of respiration and release carbon dioxide and water vapor. This carbon dioxide and water vapor is absorbed by the plants to prepare their own food, and oxygen by the process called photosynthesis. Plants store their food in the form of glucose, which also contains oxygen in it. When an animal consumes the plants, glucose enters into the animal's body, and again they release carbon dioxide during respiration. Hence, in this way, oxygen is absorbed from and released into the atmosphere, and its percent remain constant. Summary. So friends, what did you learn in this video? Water cycle, nitrogen cycle, carbon cycle, and oxygen cycle.